How's it going, everyone? It's Sam. Today we're looking at the top 10 companies to buy and hold forever. And when I say forever, you can't really look 100 years into the future, but at least for the next 10 to 20 years, I think these companies are going to do fantastic. They're really stable companies. A lot of them are very large companies. I want to go through this because we get stuck kind of thinking about day trading or thinking about the next top stock or just riskier plays. But these 10 companies, if you had bought them over the last couple months, you would be up massively. They've done quite well. They've done well for years. And I think that they're going to continue to grow into the future. So we're going to go over kind of what the company does. We're going to look at their income statement and their balance sheet. And I'm not even going to look at the price, really, the price changes over the last 6 months to a year, because with these companies, you're not looking at buying them for 5% less than they are today. You're looking at the next 10 to 20 years, what they're going to be doing. So you don't really care as much about the day-to-day fluctuations. You are just buying a stable company that's going to return you a good amount in appreciation or in dividends over the next 10, 20, 30 years. So if you like this, please leave a thumbs up. And then also, if you do want to start investing, there are links down below to Webull where you can get two free stocks, one worth up to $1,400. So you can get that and then sell it off and buy some of these stocks. And there's also a link to M1 Finance where you can start your investing journey there. They are my favorite broker for my long-term investments. So the first stock that we're looking at today is Amazon. So Amazon is a powerhouse. I'm sure you've heard of it. They have their massive website online. They're focusing on their cloud business, and they have their hand in so many different places that it's hard to really nail down exactly what they do. But in a world where we are turning more and more to online shopping, and the fact that they have all these different suppliers on Amazon and they have good affiliate programs, this is just kind of the way that the world is going. It's one of the biggest companies here in the United States and across the world. And if we just look at their revenues over the last 5 years, they've increased 107 billion. So this is with a B, billion, to 135, to 177, 232, 280, 296 over the last trailing 12 months. That's massive growth for a company their size. Looking at their net income, it's massive too, from about 596 million to 2.3 billion, to 3 billion, to 10 billion, to 11.5 billion. And this is just going to continue to grow. Looking at their balance sheet, they have about $50 billion in cash. This is just a massive amount of money that they have sitting on the sidelines. They are so big already that they can pretty much do and get into any kind of service that they want. So they have plenty of money to spend on R&D, and they're just going to continue to grow. I think that they're such a stable company. They have so many different ways of making money that I don't see a lot of people moving over to a different platform. At least in mass, I think that Amazon will continue to do well in the future. And a lot of these companies are bigger companies, like I said, but a lot of them are ones I haven't talked about. The next one is one that I've talked about, though, and it's one of my largest positions, and it is Facebook. So Facebook is one of the largest social media companies in the world. They own not only Facebook, but also Instagram and WhatsApp. So if you are outside the US, you might know what WhatsApp is. In the US, we don't usually use it very much, but it's a messaging app. And a lot of the companies and the products that Facebook owns, they're not even monetized yet. Like WhatsApp isn't really monetized. Messenger, Facebook Messenger isn't monetized. And these are massive platforms that tons of people use. Hundreds of millions, if not billions, of people use these. And if we look here at their revenues, they've been able to increase a lot too. From about 18 billion to 27 billion to 40, 55, 70. If we look at their net income, it's been able to increase from about 3 billion all the way up to about 22 and then 19. So this is just a massive amount of net income, and it's a little bit cheaper than a lot of the other tech companies in this space. I think it's a good value. I was able to buy it when it was a little bit cheaper, but I just continue to see Facebook expanding. I mean, they have a great balance sheet of about $60 billion. So for their size company, that is massive. And I think that a lot of people were worried that just new social media companies would come on the scene and people would jump over. No one's done that so far. So there have been a couple companies that have kind of come close, like Snapchat, like TikTok. I know that one's a little bit newer one, but these companies haven't been able to get into the space like Facebook. And even if Facebook had some company like TikTok that was coming up, I know TikTok might not be the best example because they are from China, but if they had some company that was getting bigger, they could just buy them out. They have $60 billion. They could buy a lot of companies out, a lot of social media companies, and just take their platform from them. So I think that they also have that option going forward. Now, the next stock is one of the last ones I've talked about a lot, and that is Berkshire Hathaway. Berkshire is one of the largest companies in the United States also. They are run and owned significantly by Warren Buffett. And this company is essentially an index fund in and of itself because it owns so many different companies completely. Then it also owns shares of a whole ton of different companies too, like Visa, like Bank of America, like Apple. They own a massive position in a lot of these companies. And as you can see here, their revenues go up consistently each year. They are trying just to continue to increase their revenues, increase their net income. They're not focused on buying speculative stocks or speculative companies. They are just looking at returning to 7 to 10% year over year and making it consistent. If we look at their balance sheet, they just have a massive amount of cash, more than Facebook, more than Amazon. They have $137 billion. They were able to buy a company recently for about $10 billion, so it might be a little bit less than this, but this is as of the last report. And they can really take advantage of a lot of different companies that are maybe down on their luck in the market. Maybe they're not in a good financial position. They could buy them out completely. They could loan to them. They could do all kinds of stuff with their $137 billion war chest right there. Now, the next company that I have on here is Google. Their revenues have just increased over the last 5 years like crazy. They had $75 billion, then $90 billion, then $110 billion, $136 billion, $161 billion. If we look at their net income, it's gone from about $16 billion on up to about $34 billion. And they have a massive amount of cash too, with $117 billion. Again, I know that these aren't stocks that are going to return probably 100% this year, but they are going to continue to grow if they are just consistent each year. And some of these companies have returned to massive amounts, like Amazon has almost doubled in the last year. So you can't really rule them out that they're going to increase massively in value. But a lot of these are trading at a little bit higher of a premium than they used to because we've seen them do so well through the pandemic and through other trying times that they tend to do very well. The next stock on the list is Apple. So Apple is one that has stayed a little bit stagnant in revenue over the last 5 years. If we look here, they went from about 234 billion to about 260. Now that's not a massive amount, and if we look at their net income, that stayed from about 53 billion to about 55 billion. However, I think that Apple is one of those companies that's just got great brand awareness and a great brand just in general. I think that a lot of people will stay with Apple just because they are Apple. A lot of people want to stay in the ecosystem. A lot of people like their product, so they can continue just tweaking the product a little bit and being able to increase in value and just continue to get revenue from their existing clients. Now, they also offer other services like the cloud. They also are getting into healthcare more. They're getting into payment processing. So I think that they're going to continue to grow extra streams of income soon. Their balance sheet also looks nice with about $94 billion sitting on the sideline. The next company on this list is a little bit polarizing, and it is Tesla. So just looking at Tesla here, their revenues have increased from $4 billion on up to about $26 billion. Now, their price has gone up really pretty substantially, but I think that it's still a great company going into the future. Their net income is still negative as of the last couple of years. But they are a company that's turning profitable. They have some of the best technology for cars. They also are really advanced in their battery technology and their self-driving cars. And they just continue to innovate at a massive level. So after they start being able to scale their production, I think that they're going to do pretty well. They also have a good amount of cash with about $8 billion. Now, they will have to probably raise some money soon because they need to build more gigafactories, and those cost about $5 billion a piece. But this shouldn't be hard for them because they are trading at quite a premium. They were down to about $350 a share just as of a few months ago. So I think this is a company where you can hold it, close your eyes for the next 5 to 10 years, and it's going to be up massively by then. The next stock on the list is Home Depot. So they have been able to consistently grow their revenue from about $88 billion up to $95 billion, up to $100 billion, up to $108 billion, up to $110 billion. Their net income has also increased from about $7 billion on up to $11 billion, and it's just a very consistent stock. Looking at their balance sheet, they have about $9 billion in cash, and they do have a nice dividend of about 2.3%. And this is on top of the fact that they've been able to increase their net income and their revenue so much. That's pretty nice to see their numbers continue to increase even while paying a nice little 2.3% dividend. And they've been able to grow this pretty substantially over the last 5 years. The next company that made the list is one that hasn't grown a lot in the revenues, but it is just such a consumer staple that I think you need to include it, and that is Pepsi. So as we see on their revenues here, they've increased from about $63 billion to $67 billion in about 4 years, so not a massive amount. Their net income has gone from about $5 billion on up to $7 billion, with $12.5 billion in there also. They do have a decent cash position with about $9 billion worth of cash and about $9 billion worth of receivables. Now, they also pay a pretty good dividend of about 3%. For a while there, when they dipped, they were even up higher than that. So it was up pretty significantly. I think it was between 4 and 5% dividend. And they've been growing this for 48 years. I think that really one of the things that they can capitalize on isn't necessarily their drinks, but their food. So they own a lot of different food brands, such as Cheetos, such as some different chips also. They also partnered with Starbucks to make a drink. I think that these are just really consistent, and people don't buy off-brand Cheetos, right? So, I mean, some people do, but a lot of people just want the $2 bag of chips or $3 bag of chips that they like. They don't want to save 25 cents by getting an off-brand. They are willing to pay for it, and they will continue to be great customers of Pepsi until they die. So that is another stock to look at for PepsiCo. It's just one that's going to be consistent over time. It's not going to massively outperform the market or anything like that, but it's just going to be consistent. The next company on the list is Visa. So Visa is a massive payment processing company that is by far the largest on the market in the US. Their total revenues have increased from about $14 billion on up to about $24 billion over the last trailing 12 months. If we look at their net income, it has gone from about $6 billion to $12 billion. They have their hands in so many different transactions. They're looking to get into peer-to-peer payments more and business-to-business payments more, while continuing to have a strong presence in the person-to-business transactions that they're used to. As you can see here, they have about $12 billion in cash, and they have a little dividend of about 0.6%. Now, this has grown by about 20% each year for the last 5 years, and it is still a fairly low payout ratio. With Visa, I think it's just one of those companies that is such a quality company. They have their hand in so many different transactions. It's just a really good source of income for them, and it's just gonna continue to pay them great revenues over the next 5, 10, 20 years. Hopefully, they can expand and just continue to increase their market share. Now, they are trading at a pretty high PE ratio just because so many people like them right now, but they are a stock to put on your watch list just in case they do dip again. I think it will be nice to pick some shares of them up. Now, I realize that I did say maybe you don't want to try to time these stocks just because you're looking at the next 10 to 20 years, but this is a company that I think will grow a little bit slower than some of the other companies on this list. And it is trading for a higher PE ratio, right around 40, compared to some of the lower PE ratios that I talked about earlier. So that's just something to keep on your radar. Now, the final stock on this list isn't really a stock at all. It's an ETF, and that's VOO, or the Vanguard S&P 500 ETF. So this is an ETF that I own in one of my portfolios. I own a lot of them in my retirement accounts in general. This is just covering the 500 US companies that make it into this list. They're some of the biggest companies in the world. It pays a little bit of a dividend, around 1.8%. And this is just a very diversified way of investing. If you look here, it was $190, $170 5 years ago. It's just consistently gone up. This is something where you are literally the market. So you have a piece of a lot of different companies. They are constantly paying you dividends. They're constantly just trying to appreciate and grow. You're basically betting on the US economy that's going to do well over the next 10, 20, 30 years. And this is one of the lower risk ways of investing in the stock market. So this is something where I hold the majority of my money in these types of funds. And they're just consistently going to do well over time. You're looking at maybe 6 to 10% return, depending on the time frame. Try not to time this. Just continue to put your money into this year after year. And in 20, 30 years, you're going to do really well. You don't have to worry about trying to pick stocks. You don't have to worry about trying to time it or do anything like that. You just put your money in, you sleep well at night, and you don't have to think about it anymore. So thank you guys so much for watching. These were the 10 stocks that I think that you can hold over the next 10, 20, 30, 40 years, or forever and not have to sell them. So let me know what you guys think below. Let me hear what stocks you're looking at and which ones you want to hold forever. I really appreciate it. I know a lot of these stocks are big name stocks, but that doesn't mean that they shouldn't be included in this list. That just means a lot of people think that they should be included in this list from what we know. Thank you so much, and use those links below if you want some free stocks, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.